Another wonderful day with the Lord. Amen. I am so grateful because of what God is doing in my life and in the life of people around me. And most of you that are watching me, I am so thrilled with the level of testimony that I receive on a daily basis about what God is doing. And I am so happy to stand here today to minister to you. Once again, my name is Pastor Dr. Tessie Aguzi, and I have the word of God for you tonight. A lot of time people think that prayer is an old thing. You know, there's no need for prayer anymore. But I have a good news for you. There's a song that says, prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master's key. Jesus started with prayer. He ended with prayer. Prayer is the master's key. I want you to understand today that prayer is the key to unlock every situation. It doesn't matter what you're going through. Prayer is the key that can unlock any situation. I see a lot of people posting videos about their businesses, about their new job, about things that they want from God. And I see very little people talk about the power of prayer. I know you can make money in so many ways. Yes, it's true. But when you connect it with prayer, when you set up this business and connect it with prayer, you will run without looking back. All those challenges that you're facing in your life, if you will get prayer involved, child of God, you will excel like a rocket. But what happened? A lot of time, they end up the era or the story or things about prayer. People do not talk about prayer anymore. But today, I am happy that you're listening to me today. I want to remind you that prayer is the only key that unlocks every situation. Amen. The Bible said that we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. I want you to understand, we do not wrestle against things we can see with our physical eyes. So if you don't wrestle with things you can fight with your physical energy, how do you fight those things? How do you stand in the days of attack? How do you push the things that you have forward in life? How do you make your marriage work? How do you make your business work? A lot of times, we consider they hate me, they did this to me. Have you projected your day? How do you do that? If you go to the book of Job, the Bible said that you should command your morning. That means any day you wake up, you are supposed to pray and command your morning. What does it mean by commanding your morning? You speak what you want to see concerning your life that day. And my brother and my sister, I want you to get it. When you begin to align yourself with the word of God, your life will completely change. Hold on, I'm bringing a sweet word for you today. I am excited in my spirit. You know why? Because I have taken time to coach people on this issue of prayer, and when they tap into it, now I am getting so much testimonies that my happiness, my heart is filled up. I am so excited because of what God is doing through prayer. Child of God, what you can do in 3 hours, prayer can do it for you in a minute. What you can achieve in 1 year, prayer can give it to you in less than a month. Prayer is not an old thing. I want you to understand, something special happens when we pray. When you pray, something big happens. Prayer is a weapon. Number one. We say that we do not wrestle against flesh and blood. It simply means there's a weapon that you're going to use to fight your physical and spiritual battles. And prayer is the key, is the weapon to destroy every and any attack of the enemy. If your life is going in a direction you don't like it, come on in. Come on in through prayer. You can change any ugly situation. My life is testimony. I have lived this life of prayer and I see results on daily basis. Continue watching. You will hear my name very soon because I've been quiet, but it's time to pop out. Child of God, I want you to understand that prayer is the key. When nothing works, prayer does. What is that trouble that you're confronting today? Or what is it do you want to change in your life? Do you say people are against you? People are fighting you? Child of God, you don't need to confront them physically. I want to give you the key. So when people think that they want to humiliate you, I want to give you a final key that you will use to unlock any kind of situation. I love to dress cute. I love to be happy. I love to celebrate, but I love to pray because this is the only solution to this life of mine. I was born from the back. I don't even have anything to see myself in front. But today, prayer can break barriers. Prayer can break barricades. Prayer can put you in front. I want to take you to the book of Acts chapter 16 verse 25. If you read till 34, you will identify that Paul and Silas found themselves in a situation. That situation, they don't have control over it. They were locked up in jail for preaching the word. I mean, their life is messed up at that moment. They don't know where to start. They don't know what to do. But they did what I'm about to tell you today. Child of God, they prayed. They prayed and they begin to sing a song to Almighty God. When they prayed and sing a song to God, the Bible said that the earth began to tremble. Earthquake began to happen and the whole prison doors were open. Power of prayer. Don't say it's in the past. The Bible says that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He do not change. He will not change. He didn't change in the past and he will not see you and change. Child of God, I want you to take your Bible back and begin to pray. Is there anybody that wants to change situation? I am telling you that my life, watch me from now till the next 6 months and see where I will be, because I am touching and I am punching situation. I am removing things out of my way. Every blocking, every stumbling block, I'm pulling them out. How do you do that? Through prayer. Yes, prayer is the key that unlocks every situation. Child of God, this is not an old news. This is not an old story. Prayer is the only key that is constant, that can change every ugly situation. It doesn't matter what you're going through. If your life is going in a good platform, child of God, it is time to maintain it with prayer. There is no time that you say, I don't need prayer. Prayer is like a bank. When you pray, you are saving your prayer in the bank, in the storage. Let me tell you, a time will come. You will need this prayer. And then the spiritual ways, the things in the spirit, God will retract these prayers that you have made today and use it to begin to work for you. As I was growing up, so many things came against us. There's no way we could have a better life. But all I know how to do well is to pray. I began to pray and I confront situation. Today, I'm in front. I went from not going to school to having PhD. Who said we can do it? My parents, they were nobody. I have a parent that worked so hard, but they were limited. Let me tell you, working hard is not making money. Because if working hard is making money, my mom should have been the richest woman in the world. She worked so hard. Child of God, working hard is not making money. You can work hard without making nothing and continue to struggle. The only way you can make money and maintain your money is to pray and commit everything you are doing into the hand of your maker. And when you do that, the spiritual things will organize you. Let me tell you, we are a talking being. When you close your mouth, you close your destiny. Get it straight. When you close your mouth, you close your destiny. God created us like himself. I like to say this over and over in all my teaching. Get it? If you don't know that you are like God, you are making a mistake. We are just more gods. That means the ability of God is in us. And one of those abilities is God can talk. And whatever you say comes to pass. Bad, good, ugly, they will come. It's only a moment. Whatever you say, whatever comes out of your mouth, whether you call it prayer, whether you call it cursing, whether you call it anger, whether you call it chatting, whatever you say will impact your life positively or negatively. Child of God, instead of you to use your mouth to create your world that will destroy you, I am praying and I am pushing you tonight to use your word wisely in prayer. Listen, I want to take you straight again to the book of Acts chapter 12 verse 5 to 11. When the Israelites, when the king arrested Peter and put him in jail, the church prayed. The Bible said that the church began to intercede for Peter. And when that happened, the Bible recorded that the king locked this man up 4 times inside where there's no intervention. And because the man knows, I have prayed, I've charted the course of my life, Peter was just sleeping and snoring. And the church prayed. Fervent prayer. And when they did that, the Bible said that heaven deployed an angel. When you pray, angels are released on your behalf. Heaven released an angel immediately, and he appeared in the prison and he tapped Peter. Peter, wake up. The time of your deliverance has come. Church has been praying. Is there any church that will still pray? Why is what you're doing not moving? Because there's no prayer. You are dry in the spirit. You got to use your word to chart the course of your life. That is the only way you can excel in life. Child of God, there's no two ways about what God can do in your life. Begin to pray. Child of God, pick up your praying mantis. Pick up all you got and begin to pray. The days are evil. Let me tell you, days are evil. Things are happening in a wrong way now. The only way you can excel is to pray. Child of God, you can change every situation. I'm telling you, I am not preaching or talking to you because somebody taught me. I'm a living testimony. I have witnessed what I'm telling you, that there's power in prayer. There is power in prayer. When you pray, something supernatural happens. When the church began to intercede for Peter, the Bible said that angel was released and he came to that prison and told Peter, get up, we got to go. Wear your shoe, wear your suit, and let's get out of this prison. Because there's no limitation to a praying woman. There's no limitation to a praying man. Let me tell you can change every situation in your life when you begin to pray, when you begin to intercede on any situation. Point your finger at whatever that is blocking you and begin to release a word of faith. Let me tell you, God does not respond by your emotions of pain, but he responds to your word. He responds to your prayer. The Bible said that the angels hearken to the voice of his command. When you pray the word of God, the angels are deployed on your behalf. This was exactly what happened to Peter. Angel was released on his behalf. And when that angel came, he said, Peter, let's go. It's time, because church, I've been praying for you. And Peter just wiped his face and like that. But he's like, maybe I'm dreaming. What is happening? I know that I'm locked up here. What is going on with my life? Well, you know, the angel said, come on, let's go. Somebody have been praying for you. The reason why your life is challenged is because there's no one praying for you. Have you got a praying mother? Have you got a praying father? Have you got a praying relationship or family? If you don't have, be the praying machine. Yeah, you can change any ugly situation in your life. That's my key. That's the only way I walk. A time came, I slowed down and things changed. But let me tell you, I pick up my praying key and I am praying like never before. There are so many wonderful men of God in the scripture. They were able to break things and go scot-free because of prayer. The angel took Peter, and when he get out of the prison, Peter find out that this wasn't a dream. It's actually reality. It's a real thing, because angel has come to save me because someone has been praying for me. I want to tell you something. Is anybody after your life? Is anyone fighting you? Is anybody trying to stop what belongs to you? Change that situation. With prayer, you can do it. I want to take you to the book of Esther. Here's the book of Esther, chapter 5, verse 13. If you read there, Haman was a guy who said, it doesn't matter that the king has lifted me up. As long as I see Mordecai alive, I am not happy. I want to see Mordecai go down. Child of God, do you know some people that you are alive smiling? They are not happy. There are some people that want to kick you out of the way. What did you do? Nothing. But I want to give you a key. I don't care who comes after me. I don't care who is fighting me. I don't care who think that I'm not supposed to be here. I know how to bulldoze them out of the way. Bulldoze people out of your way through prayer. Yes, you can do it. After all, you can sit down and talk with friends. Use the same hour, the same strategy of talking, and speak spiritual reality and change situations in your life. This man that it was called Haman made a decision. I'm going to make a way with Mordecai. There's nothing that can stop me from destroying Mordecai. But you know, Mordecai doesn't have nothing. But Mordecai had God. Mordecai had Jesus. Mordecai has our Father, the same Father we have. The Bible says that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We are working with the same God that Mordecai prayed to. Mordecai said something to all the Jewish people. This is a time of action. This is the battle time. The battle line has been drawn. Haman wants to annihilate us, and we don't stand a chance. Only if our king will fight for us. And they wore a sackcloth. This man called Mordecai, he was a praying machine. He was the same guy that prayed Esther into the throne. And he began to pray. When you pray, something significant happened. When you pray, something deep happened. When you pray, something profound happened. Child of God, there's supernatural power in prayers. When things are not moving well for you, have you tried prayer? You have tried every other thing. What about prayer? Prayer is the master's key. When Mordecai began to pray, when Mordecai began to intercede, when Mordecai began to speak mystery, do you know what happened? A day came. The king was restless. You know what? Because Mordecai took the keys of sleep from the king, and he had no choice than to begin to think. The king was restless. The king was not sleeping. He doesn't know what was happening. Let me tell you, there's no coincidence in nature. There's no coincidence in life. You can't tell me that something else was happening that king refused to sleep. It was the prayer of the saints that kept the king awake, and he was tossing back and forth. He was tossing around because he doesn't know. Let me tell you, when that tossing back and forth continued, this man, the king, he began to ask questions. Why was it this particular question? Can you someone bring me the chronicles of the king, the registry of the king? Why was it exactly what he asked for? Because somebody has been praying. God, you got to remember. Remember your people. Remember your chosen generation. Father, Haman wants to take us out. Father, you got to answer. And God knows how to intervene. It is not your duty to decide how this prayer will be answered. Your own is to pray. There's a God that knows how to answer. God made the king to become restless, and he asked for the Chronicles of the King, and he began to go through it. When he began to go through it, he identified a name. Immediately that name jumped out on him, and he's like, what is this? This man saved my life. Have we done anything for him? Why was it that same time that the king decided to look for the Chronicles of the King? And why did he choose the name of Mordecai? Because somebody is interceding in the realm of the spirit, and there's nothing that the king can do apart from him to walk in the ordinance and the direction of the Holy Ghost. Child of God, prayer change situation. I am a living witness. Prayer can move you from the back to the front. Prayer can change every ugly situation in your life. What you cannot achieve by your education and all that, prayer can give it to you overnight. Prayer still answers. There's answer to every prayer that you pray. When the king brought these Chronicles, and then the name of Mordecai jumped out on him, and he asked the question, did we do anything for this young man that saved my life? And the king, they said, no, sir, we did not. The king said, why? Why? Somebody saved my life. My life is more important than the kingdom. If I die, nothing else worth in this kingdom. Someone saved my life. We got to bless him. And the king could not rest until morning. Immediately the morning came, the king sent for Haman. Remember, Haman was the same guy who wants to take off Mordecai. But God knows how to use your enemy to bless you. Those people that want to destroy your life, those people that want to cut you off, God is going to use them to change your life. God is going to use them to break barriers. The same thing they plan for evil, the same thing God is going to use to turn the situation around. If only you will pray. Child of God, there's nothing prayer cannot change. There's no situation prayer cannot change. Begin to pray today. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter who is after you. It doesn't matter if your marriage is going down. Pray. If your life is going down, pray. If your education is not working, pray. If your business is not going, pray. When money is not coming, pray. When you cannot sleep well, pray. When your blood pressure is high, pray. There's no limit to what prayer can do in your life. Mordecai prayed, and the king was restless, and immediately he sought for solution, and he said to Haman in the morning, what will I do to a man that the king loves so much? Power of prayer. The person that king wants to, you know, bless, what can I do for him? And Haman, because he believed that he's the next guy to the king, he said, oh, king, live forever. You know what? Put your royal robe on this guy and parade him around the street. And when you're doing that, begin to say, this is the man that the king cherishes. Begin to speak. But prayer had been going on at the back. He didn't know. And the king said to Haman, go now and do exactly what you say to the guy you want to destroy. Prayer can move things around. I have seen people, they plan to give them poison in a drink, but because prayers have been made consigning their life, that water, that bottle change hands, and the person who wants to kill them drink the poisoned one. Prayer can alter any situation. When Mordecai and the entire Jews began to pray, the king said to Haman, go and parade Mordecai. Remember, Haman had already made a team and prepared a gallows that would destroy Mordecai. Do you know, if you read that scripture to the end, the same gallows he has set out was the same thing that killed Haman. I'm telling you today, whatever that has confronted you in life, as you begin to pray in the name of Jesus, those things will come down crashing. Those kingdoms will begin to pray. Break. I break every satanic kingdom fighting you. There's power in prayer. I decree and declare over your life, every ugly situation in your life, they are coming down tonight. I break them down by the power of the Holy Ghost, not by my power, but the power of Jesus Christ. Tonight I speak to your destiny. Every challenging situation confronting you tonight, they don't have a choice but to fall. The voice of the oracle of the Most High God is coming to you today, and I decree, it doesn't matter what is confronting you, they don't have a choice but to fall. The power of God is pulling them down. Child of God, go back to prayer. Child of God, go back to prayer. position in one place, walk around, begin to talk. We are talking beings. I decree and declare blessings of God is coming upon me. I decree and declare my life is changing situation. I decree and declare that this job I am taking over. I decree and declare my business is excelling. I decree and declare that my marriage is the best. I decree and declare that my children will not cause me pain. I decree and declare that my children will be the best. Wherever they go, they must be favored by God and men. I decree and declare that my life is moving upward and forward only. For the Bible said that the path of the just is like a shining light that shines bright and bright unto a perfect day. This is my declaration over my family. What is your declaration over your life? What have you been saying concerning your life? What have you been saying concerning your education, your marriage? It doesn't matter what is coming against you. You can change those situations through prayer. You can change those situations through prayer. Child of God, begin to pray. I want you to understand, it doesn't matter where you find yourself. Esther was a girl that there's no reason she would be in front. You know why? Because she was an orphan. There's nobody for her. Nobody to stand for Esther. But you know what? Power of prayer moved Esther from the back and put her in the king's palace, and she become a queen. Prayer can displace that person in the office. Prayer can displace that person that is taunting you. Any boss that you have that is working against you, don't confront the person physically. Go into your closet and begin to do what I'm asking you to do. Begin to shake foundation with prayer. You will get that person fired. Don't use your word to chat the cause in a negative way. Go into your closet and begin to pray. Let me tell you, there's no limit to what you can change, child of God. A woman of prayer is a woman that can take action. A man of prayer is a man that can take action. Child of God, begin to pray. The Bible said in the book of Jeremiah 33 verse 3, call to me and I will answer. I will show you great and hidden things. The reason why you don't know where to go is because you've not called God to give you solution to whatever you're going through. The Bible said, call upon me in Jeremiah 33:3. Call upon me and I will answer. The thing is that you got to do the calling. You got to call. Child of God, begin to call tonight. Don't sleep tonight without calling on God. Don't sleep tonight without praying. Declare what you want to see concerning your generation. Declare what you want to see concerning your life. I am coming. I have a special story in the Bible, in the book of 1 Chronicles 4:10. If you read that book, that verse of the scripture, 1 Chronicles 4, verse 10, Jabez prayed a prayer. There's a guy called Jabez. This guy was born into sorrow. You know why? The mother has so much coming against her during the pregnancy. It was a bitter experience, just like every one of us. But the woman cannot handle it. When she had her son, the woman released a curse word over the son by a name, through a name. He called the boy Jabez. Do you know what Jabez means? Jabez means sorrow. And the Bible said everything about Jabez became sorrowful. That means if people are in doing any business, if that guy come into that business, it will no longer work because his life is sorrowful and people don't want to hang out with him. People don't want to do anything with him no more simply because he is associated with sorrow. Child of God, what is your name? What is your name? My name is Tessie. Tessie means brilliant, smart girl. That's who I am. Child of God, what is your name? If you find out that your name has anything to do with your experience, change it. Begin to pray. The Bible said that this young man called Jabez was experiencing hardship, bad breaks. The other brothers and sisters don't want to have nothing to do with Jabez because he's associated with sorrow. Think about it. If you want to go into business with somebody, as soon as Jabez comes into that business, the business will no longer work. In school, he's associated with sorrow. Everything about this man is sorrowful, and people don't want to hang out with him. A day came. This guy did exactly what I'm asking you to do. Child of God, this guy went into his closet and began to pass a declaration. He said, oh God, change my name that you will enlarge my my cause. The man prayed a prayer. He changed the ugly situation. He changed the bitterness of his heart through the word of prayer. When Jabez began to pray, the Bible said God heard him and answered him. God changed his name from sorrow. He became the best guy. The Bible said that his end became more precious than his beginning. He became a king at the end of the day. And everybody wanted to hang out with him. Simply, he was able to change his situation through prayer. Child of God, what is confronting you today? It's changeable. It doesn't matter who is that. It doesn't matter what you want to achieve. All things are yours, says God. Every good and perfect gift comes from God. So if there's anything you want from God, go in and pray. You can change this situation. This is my strategy. I have another story for you in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 16. A woman called Hannah prayed. This woman had nothing about childbearing she was going through. And you know what? Just like in our days, the co-wife began to taunt her life, begin to tell her all kind of things. This woman doesn't know where to start. She is filled with sorrow, pain. She will come to Shiloh with her husband, and this woman will speak ill of her, and she will cry all through. But she did what I am asking you to do. She went into prayer. The Bible said, with all those emotion, with all those pain, with all those things she was going through, she didn't respond to her co-wife and start cussing her out and start telling her back. She went and began to pray. When Hannah prayed, the Bible said that was the last time she ever came to Shiloh as a barren woman. And not only that, God, the Bible said that God gave her the biggest prophet, God, Samuel, and then added other children to her. When you pray, something deep, something significant happens. It doesn't matter who is confronting you. There's a man in the Bible called Elijah the Tishbite. This guy, you know, he's a human being just like you and I. But he knows the strategy of prayer. A day came, this man made a prayer that there won't be rain for 365 days. Human being like you and me prayed a prayer and ceased the rain. And the Bible said it refused to rain. Heaven honored his prayer. And there was no rain in the land for a whole year. Human being like you and me. If Elijah can pray, why can't you pray? If God will answer Elijah, do you think God is not answering prayer today? The Bible said that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. My life is prayer. Everything about me has been in prayer. If not prayer, I tell you, there's nothing about me. There, one day, you know, at a time, you face struggle, you face challenges. But I tell you, every day my life is moving on upward and forward because I have learned the strategy of prayer, and I cannot do without prayer. Child of God, is anybody willing to pray? The Bible said that the weapon of our warfare, they are not carnal. They are mighty through God. What is that weapon? That's the word of God. That's prayer. Declare the word of God over every situation, and you will see God reaching out to you. Please share this video. Encourage people to pray. The reason why things are not working well for you is because you're not praying. When you begin to pray, the light will shine in your direction and things will begin to pray. I want to pray for you tonight. Those of you that are listening or those that will listen to this video, I begin to decree over your life and situation. Let everything standing as a stumbling block in your way begin to remove. In the name of Jesus Christ, I break every wall of limitation, every stumbling block, every wall of Jericho standing before you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I cut them down. I break them down. Every wall, as I'm praying, please, if there's anybody that is going through unforgiveness, release anybody and everybody in your heart. Child of God, get things out. Forgive everybody so that your prayer can be answered. Therefore, I decree over your life, you will not die younger. You will not die premature. Every attack against your life, I break it in the name of Jesus. As you listen to this word of God today, let the power that changed situation begin to happen in your life. As the church prayed for Peter and Peter received answer, today I pray that you will receive answer of all your prayers. May God intercede on your behalf. May angels be deployed concerning that situation that you're going through. May life begin to transform in your situation. May things begin to change for you today. In the name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Watch out for the next time as God prompts me. I will come out. If you have a prayer request, you can actually send it to us. And you, if you live over in Atlanta area, Georgia, please come and worship with us. You will see my page. If you go to my page, you will see the address and everything. Locate us. We have on Friday night, we have a power to change situation every Friday night. It starts 9:30. Come and change situation. Come and learn how to transform your life. If you have any family member in Georgia, please connect them to come and learn the power that can transform their life. This is the reason why we live. This is all that I do. This is my life. My getting doctorate degree is just a blessing that added to it. But my life is to take the world for Jesus Christ. If you're in with me, shout, I hear you in the name of Jesus. Let the glory of God take over your life. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah.